it up close.
I have followed too.
So can you guys see it when you drive by in your car?
Yes.
You look out the window?
Yes.
Yeah. So. Yeah. You can tell. That's a little intriguing, right? So I used a lot of different kinds of paint. I went to the paint store and got, a bunch of different colors. And some of it I used paint brushes. Some of it I used paint rollers. You know, have you seen that kind of roller that you can get lots of paint on and cover a lot of the wall really fast?
I have one in my house.
That's so cool. Me too. I've got, and for some of it, for the bees, I use spray paint. It's what they call paint that's in a can that you spray on. And that's how I can make these lines fast. So what I did, I've got a piece of metal with a bunch of tiny little holes in it. So I held the piece of metal up and I sprayed on it, and the paint went through those little round holes and it made those dots. Yeah. That's a great question. I can't reach up there. So I brought some ladders out, and even the ladders weren't tall enough. I had to get what they call scaffolding, which is this sort of like a floor without any walls that you can put things together, you build it so you can stand on top of it, and then you can reach way higher. So I had to put this together and take it down. I put it together every morning, and I took it down every night so that I could take it home with me. And I did that for about 2 weeks. Not every day, but it took me about 2 weeks every other day to get this finished. Hi.
Is there a graffiti concern?
Yes. Graffiti is what you call it when you make your writing or drawings on the wall when you don't have permission to do that. So I got permission from the Kirkwood organization. People came and asked me if I would do this artwork, this painting of bees, and then some other people came by and painted on top of it. So that was a disappointment, but there's a special coating on here that helps to seal the artwork so that I can wash it off if somebody paints on top of it. So, you know, just like when you're at home, you can't go writing and painting on the walls of the house, can you? No, that's no good. So you always, I was able to paint on this wall because I got permission. You know, that's very, very important, always. All right? Yeah, then I've got, so in over here, where do you think this is supposed to be?
Honeycomb.
That's right, it's honeycomb because it's inside the beehive. And I've got the edge of the hive here with a hole for them to get out. And when they jump out, they're flying off into the sky over there. So over here, it's really, really busy. And over there, they're flying out into the world. And it's a little bit of open space there. Some people said, aren't you going to finish it? There's a lot of open space over there. And some people said, oh, I see what you're doing there. It's setting it up to be busy here and not so busy over there. You know, a little bit of this and that. Some of you went carefully around the corner a second ago to see that the beehive is on the right on that side. There's a lot of really talented artists who live around here. So the person who made the Kirkwood sign, that's someone else. I didn't make that. And the person who did the orange landscape over there, the hills and the big owl. Did you see the owl? There's an owl down the street. The person who did these the black and white drawings of people right over here, that's somebody else. So there's a lot of really talented artists who live around here.
Like to get inspiration when you were doing the bee design, what